Hi everyone! This video will cover the nursing care of an abscess, which can develop after surgery. I've worked with many patients who've developed an abscess, so I'd like to give nurses and patients an idea of what to expect and what the recovery process might be like. In this video, I will talk about what an abscess is, its signs and symptoms, what doctors might order, how to talk your patient through what they might consider to be a major setback, treatment of abscesses, and going home. An abscess is basically a pocket of infection or pus. I'm sure everyone has had or seen a pimple being popped and the whitish yellow pus that comes out. Just imagine a huge pimple, except an abscess is caused by bacteria, and the pus is bacteria and inflammatory cells and white blood cells. But in this video, I'm not talking about any abscess. I'm talking about abscesses that occur after surgery where the surgery took place in the body. This is known as a surgical site infection. Despite all of the skin preparation, showering with antibiotic soap like chlorhexidine, and maintaining sterile procedure in the operating room, sometimes bacteria can still find a way to enter and infect the surgical area. I talk about preventive measures in another video, which I'll put up here. Surgical site infections can involve the surface of the skin, usually around the incision site. It can involve deeper tissue beneath the skin, or it can involve organs or space between organs. When the doctor tells patients that they have an abscess, they are usually referring to an abscess in the space between organs. But patients, make sure you ask exactly where it is and if it does involve organs. Here are some signs and symptoms of an abscess. Patients might spike fevers higher than 100.4 Fahrenheit. This usually happens around post-op day 2 to 4, but everyone is different. Blood work might show an upward trend of white blood cell count. Patients might report pain in a localized area and tenderness when pressed on. You might even be able to feel a mass when palpating. The area might be red, hot, and swollen. If the abscess is close to the skin, pus might come through the incision or even push through intact skin. Let's say your patient starts to spike fever. You report it to the doctor and they need to find out what's causing it. Post-operative fevers could be a sign of UTI, atelectasis, pneumonia, surgical site infection, or pulmonary embolism. All of these are serious, so all of their orders will probably be stat orders. We'll get blood cultures following the hospital procedures to avoid contamination. This will tell us if there's an infection in the bloodstream. We'll get a urine sample to see if it's a UTI, especially if the patient has or had a urinary catheter. Next, we can give antibiotics. This must be given after the blood cultures are taken. Doctors will probably order broad-spectrum antibiotics until they know exactly what the organism is. Patient will go down for a CAT scan. If they are able, they will need to drink contrast solution and have a 20 gauge or larger IV in the AC for pushing IV contrast. The CT scan will show us if there is an abscess and where it is located. Sometimes the abscess pushes through the incision and starts draining from there. Sometimes the abscess pushes through intact skin and drains from there. In those cases, dressing changes must be done or a wound pouch placed to collect the drainage so that it does not break down the surrounding skin. Other times, the patient will go to interventional radiology to have a drain placed, and other times, they will take the patient to surgery to open them up and wash out the infection. Whichever way, the pus needs to be evacuated. Also remember that you should give the patient antipyretics like acetaminophen for fevers. Now this will be a lot for the patient. They were expecting to have surgery, recover, and go home, and now they're having more pain, fevers, tests, procedures, and they have to stay in the hospital longer than expected. So to make their stay a little less painful, explain every procedure and answer all of their questions about the doctor's orders. Try your best to update them on the plan. This is the best thing, especially for anxious patients. Anxiety can strain your relationship with the patient. Reassure your patient that an abscess is, yes, a bump in the road, but it is treatable. Make sure you are managing their pain and fever, but also remind them that laying in bed is counterproductive and will put them at risk for other complications. Encourage them to take walks and to stay in the chair and out of bed during the daytime. If the doctor decides that a drain needs to be placed, the patient will go to interventional radiology. Contrast will be injected through the skin to visualize the abscess using a CT scan. This is an abscessogram. The doctor will then insert a flexible tube into the abscess. The tube will come out of the skin and have a clear rubber bulb on the other end. The bulb has a port that is open to dump out the drainage. Before closing the port, squeeze the air out of the bulb. When the port is closed, the negative pressure will gently pull out the fluid from the abscess as the bulb expands. As the abscess resolves, the fluid will change from a purulent milky yellow color to a clear pinkish fluid. Repeat abscessograms might be necessary to reposition drains or place new ones. Now, once the patient has gotten their course of IV antibiotics, the fevers are gone, they're walking, they've met all of the milestones necessary to go home, they just have this drain, they can go home with it. Patients will likely go home with PO antibiotics, make sure they know exactly when to take it and for how long, educate them on side effects. Doctors may also prescribe or recommend that patients get probiotics over the counter. This is recommended for long-term antibiotic use because antibiotics can kill necessary gut flora. Most patients go home with the drain in place. Teach them how to empty it, record the output, and keep it clean. Secure the tube and bulb so that it doesn't accidentally get pulled or yanked out. For abscesses that push through the skin, once the infection has resolved, the drainage will eventually stop and the wound will close up from the inside out. Supply the patient with wound supplies and dressings to keep the site clean. And that's all I have on abscesses after surgery. Thank you for watching. Please comment, like, and subscribe for more nursing videos.